students, I hope you all are doing well. In this section of my video, we'll be going through an important logic, derivation and expression of potential energy of a dipole when kept in a uniform electric field. Now, going initially through the concept of potential energy, that what actually potential energy is. As you have gone through the concept in class 11th, that potential energy is actually the energy possessed by the body by the virtue of its position. I am repeating it. Potential energy is the energy possessed by the body by the virtue of its particular position. But in this case, we are dealing with the concept of dipole which is being kept in a uniform field. Hence, we can define potential energy of a dipole is the energy possessed by the dipole by the virtue of its position in that particular field, which means that here you have kept dipole in a uniform field. As we have studied in the previous section, that whenever you are keeping a dipole in a uniform field, it experiences a torque, and the magnitude of torque that we have calculated as Pe sine theta. Now, go through this figure. Again, as you can observe this figure, these horizontal lines represents the uniform electric field. A dipole is kept in this uniform field. We have calculated in the previous section that torque acting on the dipole at any instant as Pe sine theta. Let this be equation number 1. Now, in order to rotate this dipole in this uniform field, we need to apply some force, or you can say we need to do some work on the dipole if we need to rotate this dipole in the given field. Therefore, a small amount of work is done in rotating the dipole, starting small work done in rotating the dipole dw equals to torque d theta, where dw represents the small magnitude of work done, tau represents the torque acting on the dipole, which is Pe sine theta, d theta represent the range of that particular angle in which you are rotating the dipole. Now, moving on to carry out the derivation, dw equals to Pe sine theta d theta. Pe sine theta d theta. Therefore, net work done, or you can say total work done in rotating the dipole from theta equal to theta 1 to theta equal to certain theta 2. That means we are rotating the dipole between these two angles. That is theta equals to theta 1 and theta equals to theta 2. Therefore, calculating net work done by integrating both sides. Integration of Pe sine theta d theta. Limits theta 1 to theta 2. Integration of dw is w Pe integration of sine theta is minus cos theta. Limit theta 1 to theta 2, taking this negative sign outwards, minus Pe cos theta, theta 1 to theta 2, minus Pe cos theta 2, minus cos theta 1. So this is the expression of work done in rotating the dipole by the angles theta 1 to theta 2, minus Pe cos theta 2, minus cos theta 1. Now in this expression, you have calculated the magnitude of work done. Now consider that, considering angle theta 1 is equals to 90 degree and angle theta 2 is equals to theta, which means that initially the dipole is kept perpendicular to the direction of electric field and the net work done has rotated the dipole to a certain angle theta. Substituting these values, we have minus PE cos theta minus 0, as the value of cos 90 will be 0. Minus PE cos theta. Hence, the expression which comes out here of the net work done in rotating the dipole at a certain angle is minus PE cos theta. This work done corresponds to the potential energy which is stored in the dipole. This work done corresponds to the potential energy which is stored in a dipole, given by the expression U is equals to minus PE cos theta. Again, observing this expression as A B cos theta in the scalar form. Again, A B cos theta, which means the expression for potential energy can be written as P dot E. That is, if you expand this P dot E, you will get P cos theta. Now, going through this expression, you can observe that the expression which you have calculated in the expression of torque, it was a cross product of dipole moment in electric field. While in this concept, that is the energy, the expression is appearing as a dot product of dipole moment and field. So this is a point which is to be considered or noted from the two relevant expressions. So this was all about the work done and potential energy of a dipole. I hope you have understood this well. Thank you.